I thank God for his many blessings. I thank him that he continues to watch over us and keep us. I greet you this morning in the name of my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you for this day. We thank you, Lord, that you have opened our eyes to see a brand new day, Lord God. And because you have led us to this day, Father God, we know that you would lead us through this day. Father God, we thank you that you continue to watch over us and keep us, Lord God. Father, we thank you, Lord, that every blessing comes from you, Lord. Help us, Father God, to count our blessings and realize your goodness and your mercy, to give you all the praise, all the glory, and all the honor. Lord God, let this devotion touch us this morning. Help us to realize, Lord God, where you are speaking to us, Father. And Lord, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. I am reading first from two scriptures, Ephesians 5, 26 to 27. Ephesians 5, 26 to 27 in the New King James Version. That he might sanctify and cleanse her with the washing of water by the word, that he might present her to himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that she should be holy and without blemish. Isaiah 48:10. Behold, I have refined you, but not as silver. I have tested you in the furnace of affliction. The title of this devotion this morning is No More Wrinkles. No More Wrinkles. This devotion came out of a brief conversation I had with my granddaughter this week. I was ironing her clothes for school and she said, Gammy, why do you have to iron my clothes? Does the iron make them soft? I said, no, baby. The heat from the iron takes out the wrinkles. The shirts were washed, but do you see these creases and wrinkles in them? Well, you can't go to school with them wrinkled like this. So the heat from the iron removes the wrinkles. Immediately, the Holy Spirit spoke to me. Jesus washes us clean, but sometimes there are some wrinkles that have to be removed before he presents us to do his work. Maybe this revelation was just for me alone, but I still feel led to share it with you today. Isaiah 48 and 10 says, behold, I have refined you, but not as silver. I have tested you in the furnace of affliction. The word refine means to remove everything impure and increase in value. When everything impure has been removed, we increase in value. Some of us wonder why we go through the furnace, but we don't realize that a refining process is taking place. When we use the iron to press the clothes, it is a process as we try to remove the wrinkles from every area of the garment. To have one part well pressed and the other part wrinkled does not speak well of the person using the iron. Ironing our clothes takes time. A process takes time. The process can be slow and tedious, but the wrinkles must go. No more wrinkles. The heat we sometimes go through is to remove the wrinkles from our lives. You see, when we are in the heat, we pray more, we seek God more, we spend more time in his presence, we read his word more. That's why we are in the heat, to take out the wrinkles. Ephesians 5, 26 and 27 says that he might sanctify and cleanse her, speaking about the church, with the washing of water by the word. First we are washed. That he might present her to himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that she should be holy and without blemish. Yes, we were washed and cleansed to remove the spots, but now the wrinkles have to go in order for us to be presented to God and also to others as a holy body without blemish. When God has matured us, there will be no more wrinkles. If the shirts could talk, do you think they would like the heat of the iron? Sometimes the material requires high heat. The coarser the material, oh God, the higher the heat. That is why the settings on the iron starts at nylon and ranges all the way to linen. Because the coarser the material is, the higher the heat we have to use. My God, how coarse are us this morning? How coarse are we this morning? What setting does God have to use on us? Excuse me. How coarse are we? How tough are our wrinkles? How high is the heat? Wrinkles can be removed. Wrinkles of anger, wrinkles of pride, wrinkles of unforgiveness, wrinkles of hatred, wrinkles of gossip, lying, greed, lust, prayerlessness, just name a few. Each of us knows what our wrinkles are, but we don't like the heat. Zechariah 13:9 reads, I will bring the one-third through the fire, will refine them as silver is refined, and test them as gold is tested. They will call on my name, and I will answer them, and I will say, this is my people. Hallelujah. And each one will say, the Lord is my God. When we have gone through the fire, God can boast about us. This is my people, and we can boast that the Lord is my God. Have you ever been in the place where you felt if it is not one thing, it's another? Why does this fiery trial have to be so hot? Why? Somebody may tell you it's because you lost step with God. I remember that Jesus healed a blind man, and the people asked him, who sinned, this man or his parents, that he was born blind? People will sometimes define your situation to something that you did wrong. But you know you are in right standing with God. Jesus said, neither this man nor his parents, but this happened that the works of God may be displayed in him. Sometimes when the refining fire comes, it is because you have said, Lord, I am available to you. And God wants to display himself in you. You have said, I want more of you. Set me on fire for you. But we don't realize that in order for us to be set on fire, we must go through some fire. Hallelujah. Then the refining process begins. We have been washed, yes, but the wrinkles must be removed before we are presented. My sister-in-law's ceramics have to go through the fire or they will crumble under pressure. No more wrinkles. Of course, some more wrinkles may appear in the course of our work, but the heat removes those as well. The scripture compares purification to the process to purify silver and gold. God does not cause suffering, but he may allow the furnace of affliction, the devil's attacks, in order to cleanse us and mold us, shape us into what he would have us to be. Not who we want to be with all our wrinkles, but how God wants to present us, hallelujah, without spot, without wrinkle, without blemish. God has confidence in us that we will continue to trust him in the midst of the heat. So we go through the process of refining and purification. I said go through because there is an end to the process. I remember the song that the regenerated singers used to sing, I can almost see the end from here. There is an end to the process. I remember speaking of the process of silver and gold in a previous devotion, so I'm just going to make it brief. In order to get pure silver and gold first, the rock has to be broken to reveal what is inside. Broken to reveal. There is a treasure inside of us, hallelujah, and we have to be broken to reveal what is inside. Glory to God. Then all of the impurities have to be removed, and this is done by fire. Sometimes the gold or the silver is removed, shaped, and refined, and returned to the fire, sometimes up to seven times. We know the number seven. During the heat process, the impurities that rise to the top are removed. I declare now that in this process you are going through, every impurity, every wrinkle in our lives will be removed in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. The person implementing this purifying process keeps a close eye on the metal being processed. Just so during our refining process, God keeps a close eye on us. He has not left us. He is always with us. The songwriter says his eye is on the sparrow, and I know he watches me. His eye is on me, hallelujah, during this process. This gold or silver stays in the fire until it is shining so bright that the person fashioning it can see a reflection of himself in it. Somebody will shout right there. When we go through the fire, all the impurities are removed and God can see, hallelujah, his reflection in us. God said they will call my name and I will answer them. If you are going through the fire or the heat of the iron, the process will end. There will be no more wrinkles and you will be a reflection of your Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. We want to be a reflection of him. We want to live like him. We want others to see Jesus in us. Not when we get to heaven, but right here on this earth. We want to be a reflection of him. But we don't like the fire. But the fire, the heat, will remove the wrinkles that we may be presented. Hallelujah. Glory to God. No more wrinkles, ready to be presented. Father, we thank you this morning for this brief word that you have given to me, Father. But Lord, I thank you for the process. I thank you, Lord God, for the refining process that we go through. Lord God, because it removes our wrinkles. The wrinkles sometimes that nobody else can see but you, Lord God. But we know, Father. So God, help us to be aware, hallelujah, of the things that must be removed in this process. And help us to come through this process, Father, shining even brighter for you. No more wrinkles, ready to be presented. Bless us this morning, Father. Bless Evangelist Burns and this radio station and everyone here listening, Father God. God, I thank you for the process. I thank you, God. I thank you and I praise you in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. The Lord bless you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon you and give you his peace. May God give you a blessed and fruitful weekend. I love you.